Hello, here we are, day two of the Europe International Championships. So, yeah, it's going to be an interesting day. It is about 8:10 now, and I think it's probably the earliest I've ever got up to the Excel Centre for a convention, I suppose you could say. But yeah, it's a wee bit nippy up here. It's a bit chilly. It's a bit chilly in the old willy. But yeah, so. It's also going very slow. It's a bit windy today. It's very windy, so it's fine. Obviously, we're literally going at a snail's pace now, which is a bit annoying, but it's fine. I need to be there at the Pokemon Go area by 8:45, so I should have decent enough amount of time, so that's good. Yeah, once I do that, then it's like all the palaver of like, oh, you know, announcements and people and yada 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 yada, all that jazz. And then at 9:00 I'll be heading on into it. And then I don't really know how it's gonna work from there. It'll just be, I think, the top two people will go on through. And yeah, I don't think I'm gonna get too far. I'm just gonna obviously enjoy it, see how I go. I did make a last minute substitution last night. Apparently, for whatever reason, the submissions didn't close until like 7:00 this morning. I was like, okay, cool. So I topped out a Toxicroak for a Venusaur. So yeah, I realised how good my Venusaur was. Well, I won't say good, but he was helpful in one of the Great Leagues a little while ago for the kind of Easter time special cup, whatever it was. So I thought, you know what, I'll quickly give him a Frenzy Plant TM, you know, from the special charged ones. And it'll be elite, what they call them, the elite charged TMs. And then, you know what, I thought, fuck it, add him on the team. Actually, trade from one of my friends, actually, as well, so, my mate, so, yeah, it's quite funny. But yeah, so as someone else, I also my team, I've also got a Lantern. I can't even think of else. I've got Umbreon, Sunfisk, Galarian, and I kept Zumarill, and I also had Noteria. So yeah, so I tried out those three boys, Noteria, Sunfisk, and Umbreon yesterday on the on-demand Great Leagues. Done quite well, done pretty decently. So again, as I say, yesterday won two matches out of three, so pretty damn good, I would say. But obviously, now I'll be facing people who will be knowing what they're doing. So, I mean, the last guy I beat, it was like, he had two fucking flying types. I was like, my Stunfist literally breezed through. So, but hey ho, doesn't matter. So we'll see how far I get. I don't think I'm gonna get too far. I'm just gonna see, just gonna enjoy it. Just gonna have fun. Just gonna see how we go. But it'd be fun as well if I get like points, like battle points. That would be awesome, because then I can use those battle points to, contribute towards the prize wall stuff. And I'll depending on how quickly I get knocked out, I'll probably just, you know, add on some more on-demand leagues and stuff, and maybe go to the other kind of scheduled Pokemon Go tournament, whatever they have. So I'll try to do that on the side events. I also do have the Pokemon Center booked. Sadly, I should have booked it for a bit earlier, maybe. But yeah, I got that booked for fucking 9:15. That's no good. So it depends on how long I'm gonna be there doing the battlings. Unfortunately, I think rather a long time. So yeah, not a good time. So maybe if I'm lucky, I can just be like, hey, I had 9:15, can I go to the front of the queue and just get straight on in? Hopefully they'll allow me to do that. If they don't, then it's going to be a fucking pain in the ass, because it's going to be like, either it's going to be, oh no, you missed transports, you can't come in, and then I'm fucking jobs left being like, you know, fucking just a dickhead who's like, you can't come in, your time slot's gone, baby. Then I send the Boris Johnson. Anyway. Yeah. So it's either that or they'll be like, oh yeah, go straight on in, and then they'll be like, sweet. So hopefully it's the latter, not the former. But we'll see how the day goes. It'll be interesting, it's gonna be fun, it's gonna be good. I'm excited, I'm looking forward to it. But I need to get into the exhale center because it's fucking freezing. So, yeah, just coming down on the descent now, and yeah.
How they doing? How they doing for the construction? I'm always checking the construction things. What they got down there? Fucking hell, what's gone wrong down there? What's going on, Danny?
Good enough. Anyway, I will see you guys in a bit. Bye.
So here we are again. Here it is. Here it is. It's starting to rain again now, actually. It's pretty good timing. So yeah, I wonder what happens to all the kind of banners and stuff they have. Like all the banners that hang up and stuff, and all the ones that are in like stand-up kind of stands. Stand-up stands? Doesn't make sense. Stand-up kind of metal pole things. What do I do with them all? I guess put them back in storage. Oh, nice. I think I saw that last time. Oh, they had that on last time. Pretty neat. I'll take a picture of that real quick. I don't know if I haven't looked at this last time. It's just a bit still online anyway, still on the thing. It's funny, yesterday when I came along into the inn, they had all the pig juice. It's like, oh, they put a banner up now. Hello, thank you. Cheers. Free hatch, reminds me of fucking our... did today, yesterday. Just reminds me of their sap up episodes, free hat. Free hat, yeah, free hat, free. Yeah, those stands. Those stands, kind of thing. Those ones. Also, all the banners, big little banners. I guess they should put them back in storage. They just destroy them. But yeah, I'm going to slowly make my way over to the go area, just so I'm there for being early, I suppose. And yeah, it's quite nice. It's actually quite dead at the moment. It's going to not last that long. So. Yeah, did you? I think I saw him in front yesterday. He's got his ass. It's a Pokemon's ass. All the judges and a chill. Oh, lovely. So curious how Rob did yesterday. And for Rob. So you get your points over there, so hopefully I'll get some points. Side areas, good to go. So it's all good. Pairings online, and there's the go area, which seems rather fucking swamped. I think that's about 207 people, I think there was online, I saw. So odd kind of number, but yeah, here we see all of the televisions. At least the screens, I suppose. So. Yeah, this is all swamped out yesterday. It's fucking hilarious to see it all dead. Again, it's funny to see that all dead. Here are the trophies. Damn. I like the little kind of pokey funny, you see it, the fucking little pokeball things, plant pots they got, so quite cool. Damn. Whew, this is busy. I'm gonna get careened at the competition. It's gonna be a slaughter for me. I'm gonna die quickly, but oh well, doesn't matter. I'm here for fun. Also give you like iPhone 10s or 11s, whatever they are. No, 10s. Maybe like 13s, 14s, I don't know what they are, but they give you phones to use, sign into, so that's pretty good. So, yeah. Pandemonium. These are all my competitors. Well, I'm gonna get bathed, but even still, who cares?
This is day two of our competition, and I hope you're excited as I am to kick things off today. I'm Adam Watson, and I'm Tom Lagos. In case you missed yesterday's clips, matches, and news, have nothing. Today is expected to be filled with even more action. Pokemon Video Game, Pokemon Trading Card Game, Pokemon Go, and Pokemon Unite.
playing is A through D, as you can see there. So, yeah, it's all. Most players we had, apparently, 256, so fucking insane. Absolutely insane. Hoping my fucking authentication works, my two factor, but yeah. So, just seeing a disconnection on the DD side. I don't know who it was, but someone's going to lose a round, I think. Match. That's pretty crappy of them. I managed to win my first round for my team. So, yeah, managed to do it. I'm happy. So, round two, through the second round now. Through the second round now. So, yeah. I'm wanting to lose, but we'll see how we go. It's gonna be interesting. And if I lose, I still get to lose this bracket, so see how we do. Hopefully I'll win. I think I did pretty okay. I'm learning a bit more on how to do it all. I don't know, guys, if you guys can hear me too well, but yeah. These guys are just going through the Pokemon names while we're waiting for all the people to finish. I don't know who's supposed to go on stage. Let's be people going on stage. Things like, I don't know how to do it on here, but random people can go onto the stage and stream, which is interesting. So you may see me on stream, never know. But, yeah. So, I lost the second round. It played on the lantern, unfortunately. So, a bit of pain. But yeah, so awful. I'm going to play someone who's just playing now. We're finishing in a minute, hopefully. And then I'll be playing again. If I lose again, then I'm out completely. If I win, then I keep going. So, yeah. But yeah, doing well. And in high spirits, at least. Your boy is out. I lost. Yeah. Didn't do too well. I lost. So, it's alright. It's all fun playing, I suppose. Would have been fun to get further. Must get to round 3 at least, but yeah. Didn't plan out that way. So, oh well. Whatever. So, rest of the new stage still going on, which is awesome. So, just gonna quickly retreat out to see if I can get into the centre. I doubt it. If I can, perfect. If not, then fuck it. I hope to come tomorrow. After that, I'm going to have a little look through, see some people who in the booth doing the cards, including Kuma cards. So I'll see her Kuma cards store. So I mean, everything. I can see people here. Look, all just running along. See, so yeah, people sending shit in the booths. So interesting. So let's see if I can get in. I doubt they'll let me in because they'll probably be fucking busybodies this morning. But if I'm in luck, we'll never know. So, doubt they have any bags. They'll be sold out, more than likely. But yeah, worth a shot. Yeah, I had fun. That was pretty good. I enjoyed that. I need to get better at the competitive because I need a Medichan, I need a Knocked Out, I need a Registeel, I need a lot more. So pain in the ass. Well, at least we tried. At least we did halfway decent. So, you know, it's all about the fun, participation, and also the fact that, you know, I mean, I did get some exclusive stuff. So, you know. I'm not gonna lie, I've had a lot of nice hats and stuff. Great. Or bank account. But yeah, so just heading down to the centre now. We'll see how we go about it. I might be able to get in, I might have a way. but we'll see how we go. I keep saying that. Sorry. But see you then. See you hopefully inside, maybe. I'm in the queue. Hooray! They made me through. They let me through, so I'm happy. So I'm not going to be able to get anything good though. But you know, to the Pokemon Center, you know. I'm in though. I'm happy. I kind of was wishing that they would be like, oh, you know, going ahead because, you know, competing and, you know, but whatever. I guess a lot of people are doing that as well, so. I'm going to wait about another hour. Fun. So people learn to play as well. Neat. So I'm in. Pandemonium everywhere. Those skateboards are nice. Yeah, as I thought. Literally nothing. It's literally nothing. All that kiss today. That stuff nice. Yeah. All the mats were there yesterday. Everything's all sold out. So that lovely gent there just told me that they sold 1,200 backpacks in one day yesterday. 1,200. And there wasn't a limit on the backpacks. That's why they fucking went so quickly. So that is a load of horseshit. I tell you, that is absolute horseshit. I can't believe that they've allowed that. Playmax was like, yeah, one person. Bags, nah. Ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Which means not a lot for me to actually want to get now. Really. It's a shame. Sorry. Hey, people.
Daryl.
For
you. This is the last one, apparently.
This is
the last one.
Goddamn hate rude people. I bump into each other. I say sorry. He doesn't like that fool. Fucking brick. Honestly. Anyway. Sorry. Still good stuff. Still a lot of good stuff here, but. Oh. See the Quaxley. Poor Quaxley's the only one left. That Latios statue does look pretty nice. I've only got Gen 1, Gen 2. Gen 5. Where's Gen 5 fits? I don't think I'm actually going to buy anything. This is,
Oh wait, it's fire when you
get them. Yeah, so they've not got a sign for LED, I'm just like, yeah, they're not.
Mickey, I've already got that at the pop-up London Centre ages ago. So, 12 o'clock, literally bang on 12 o'clock. I've got a bunch of stuff. Stuff I'm going to open for the unboxing channel. Things I might open here. I might open a few tins of Crown Zenith here. I did buy two more blisters of Silver Tempest. I don't know if I'm going to open them here or not. I was going to originally, but now I'm thinking, maybe for the channel. So I don't know. I really don't know. But yeah, so we are moving along. We're going to go over towards individual people selling stuff. See how things are there and see if we can buy anything there as well. Doing some trade maybe or something, but yeah,
see if there's anything of noteworthiness in the people's individuals things, selling things. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. I'm too hungry. There is a lot of food that's calling to me, unfortunately. And I haven't got lunch. I have lunch, but I have. That consists of two packets of crisps, salt and vinegar, cheese and onion crisps. So, not great, unfortunately. But, no, chicken. So, yeah, here we go. These are where the people's is at. So let's see what we can see, shall we? Nice.
Sleeves. Nice.
Chocolate strawberry, look at that, nice.
We've got lots of
sort of like a fucking little stall there.
More, but they've gone. You can see it's evolution, you know what they're like.
Yes.
I have 5 minutes.
I wish I could probably come here, but like, oh wow.
All these trophies are for sale as well, obviously.
Sorry?
All these trophies for sale as well, obviously.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
How much are the trophies each?
Which one? Like 200 champion and 100 the other one.
So fine, okay. Cool. Thanks. Oh, these guys got quite... Yeah, these guys have got the big ass pace. Yeah, these ones had some good stuff last time. Back at Worlds, but it's too crowded at the moment. This is why I got my. Some of my Neo stuff from them. Ooh, my shorts. Different.
I just had to ask, how much are the two packs McDonald's?
The
two McDonald's packs, promo packs.
That's 150 and that's 400.
Jesus.
I'm
tempted to one at 150, but it's like, when I buy it, I'm like, do I open it?
Yeah, that's the problem.
So,
there's only one card in there.
That's what I mean, yeah.
So we're going back in again, and I had a bit of lunch on my own, obviously. I don't know why I said that. Had a bit of lunch, and opened up some Pokemon packs, some crowns and stuff. I'll probably flash up a quick clip and show what I got. Got some good stuff, and here's where they had put all the barriers and stuff. And so having plenty of fun. I need to go do some prize roll stuff, hopefully. So I haven't got enough for a lot of stuff. I've only got, 130 I think I had. So, I'm just putting him over here to some, card shops, Brotherhood and Magic. She's very excited. And, yeah. I'm gonna look around here, potter about here for a bit, go back over to the side events, see if there's any side events I can do. If there is, great. If not, I'll wait. I'm gonna go watch some stuff for a bit. And, yeah, potter around for a bit. About a bit. Got some guy selling some nice cards. But I didn't end up getting anything, unfortunately. Oh, just the lines are cashing your cards. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. We've got to do it a bit later on then. Got nice stuff. It's all new stuff, unfortunately. But then again, there's just some nice stuff.
Oh, that's
one of
the boys
that
I've got cash in, so
35 nicker. Maybe we get 15 or 20 for him, maybe, if I'm lucky. Doubt it, but I'll probably get 10 of them. Either way. Quieter today over here.
There's a lot of nice cars here, though, I must admit.
Yeah, but no, it's not that.
Sorry.
Have we got any?
Okay, so entered into the Great League in gold. So we're doing that at 2:15, it's about 20 to 2 now. So I'm going to potter about for a bit. I may watch the stuff actually. And then I'm going to go over to the go area and try to redeem myself a little bit. So it's 30 points and 60 points plus every win. So 3 rounds for fucking win, 60. So I can get 150 points. Could get 150 points. That would be quite nice. So if I do that, then I'll have 280. This is not a whole lot. I don't know what I can get, 280. But yeah. Still,
so much fun. So much fun.
So,
good stuff.
All of the funds. I've opened some cards, I've never mentioned before, but I've opened up some more cards. Some Leon tin, they've got absolutely nothing. Absolutely shat on. So, yay. But then I got the whole tin set, so something I wasn't going to do, but I did it anyway. Let's see what money spent this weekend. See you in a bit.
It's anyone's game. Yeah, what's been your favorite unique Pokemon today so far?
Tom and Tomaret is looking broken after that attack.
Here we go, Gotlu up in our top path, getting some experience right here as we have multiple members up announced, possibly getting ready for the fight here in the center. But looks like Talon needs to help with a lot of packs. The Bobo's putting points on the board, no one there stopped.
Gazu wants these birds that do get a good crop on them. Are they going to engage on Toon though? Toon's feeling very aggressive with their support squad around them. And Zerv, as we know, has the ability to keep these players healthy and strong and fighting.
Here we go. Rob pushing forward here, getting Mangu to peel back a little bit. Toon already level 7 right here. Looking great. We've got a level 7 on our Decidueye as well, which means it has evolved. It does have that Spirit Shackles on the bottom path. Gotlu chasing this down. Toon coming right back in to see if it can pick up a KO right here. Gotlu in a lot of trouble, and it does get out. Sixie's coming back, though, for a nice pickup on that KO, secured by the Hoopa, who gets sent up into the air. Huge Spirit Shackle. Now Buzzwole's got to run here. Who is able to take this down? No! He slammed him down and sent him back home through the hyperspace hole. Come on!
And Daisu coming through, putting tons of pressure on, forcing Klaus to take both berries with the hyperspace highways back open. And we've got the basement Reggie here. Lundru's all over Grub. They're half HP. They get snuffed by the surf. They're drowning a little bit. Forced to retreat. Grub has tons of HP gone. They're going to flank out, catch the reset with the Hoopa Geese.
Reggie Seal getting very low right here. We don't have incredible secure Spirit Shackle, but we do have a Talonflame who takes it to the sky right here. A little too early, secured there by the Slowbro. Once again, first Reggie taken by Meg.
Why use abilities when you can just press B, Sprinkles? They're getting it done. Megu seals up another objective. They've had a couple of those in this matchup only. And you know when you get one from Slowbro, you're like, okay, we didn't expect that, but we're happy we got you.
We go up to the top path right here. Looks like they might be keeping it around here at the bottom path. I don't know. He might want to weigh up there right now as we are fighting over Reggie like he's just being ripped apart here by now. It's big secure from the Spirit Shot.
Believer's got Rayquaza, but the points are going in the other way.
332, 389. This is not over even though they did not secure Rayquaza, but more points are going in for Tally Bobo as they run towards this central area. Now it's Esports scoring at the main base. With more points looking to score. They are still behind. They need to make this happen. 382, 549, 25 seconds left on the clock. Tally Bobo believers are trying to shut this down right now as four members of Tally Bobo move towards this bottom goal. They are trying to get points and ensure this lead is shrinking, but it's still over 100 plays. Gun Unite, they're going to be able to shell in a ton of damage. Weingart tries to make it happen. Slow beam comes through. Tally Bobo believers are seeing you. They've got 60. Takes this, they win right now. No!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Brother.
They take Rick Ways in a big way. Service nonetheless. The Elder God sealing it up, but the tidal wave came back immediately the other way. Crashing on their own goal path, crashing on the beach, 200 points separate them, and the push of an absolute century with points raining in with no time on the clock.
Tally Bobo believers get it done once again. Now wow. T-Sports looking incredible. Valiant effort right here means the Tally Bobo fans absolutely ecstatic in the crowd. Incredible stuff. Absolutely time to hug it up. That was a war. That was still looking incredible right here, but now having a fantastic performance. Tally Bobo, however, I would say cementing their place as the number one team in the EU. Maybe even cementing their place as the best team in the world. We're going to see if anyone can ever knock them off that pedestal. Another thing that's on a pedestal is some Chaos Cup trophies, and they're going to be handed over to Tally Bobo.
They have, that is a visual representation, a physical representation of how dominant this team has been. To put that on your bookshelf is something that they've been thinking about since they got here. The money's great, the championship points are important, but that trophy, like Chris Hero said, stitches you in the history books of Pokemon Unite.
There we go. This audience so excited about this victory right here. I mean, what a... We have Zoinks on the main stage with our grand finals champion, Tally Bobo believers. Take it away, Zoinks.
To be on stage with your grand champion, the Tally Bobo believer, one more time, your champion today. From the winter sun. They got close near the end, but how did it feel going into a bracket reset versus a team as strong as Nouns?
It's a bit scary, but you know, like it's just a whole new set. Just gotta focus on that one game at a time.
Fair enough. All right, we are going to give the mic here over to Mega, and Pikachu is here on stage congratulating as well. Mega, here you are. What an incredible game win. Your Slowbro, Stump of Legends, turning heads all weekend long. I mean, you look like the best Slowbro in the world.
I'm just playing my role. I've been a great team, an amazing team with me. And I think that's all. I just believe in them, they believe in me. And this is where the work is doing.
And Zervis, the team captain. You've got this team through thick and thin. It got pretty thick in this matchup as you had a very close game and an amazing finish in this matchup. Down to the wire. I mean, how do the comms look in a situation like that?
A little bit chaotic. We kept telling chill, but in the end we just put through and we were all so happy. As the new ones and Klaus and me who did not have the best run last year in London, so it means the world to us. So happy.
Amazing. And Klaus, what a performance from you. So many different Pokemon on the battlefield. It looked so good. Talent looked amazing. I mean, you've earned a lot of fans today, but do you have anything to shout out towards your fans at home?
Thank you for cheering on me. I will do my best in the next cup, and hopefully this year we will in Japan.
Dylan Roop, you had some pretty big shoes to fill in for a squad like Tally Bobo Believers, but I think you convinced everybody here today you deserve to be up on this stage and hoisting that trophy. I mean, how does it feel to be filling it for Tally Bobo and winning the whole thing?
It feels amazing. Obviously, it's hard to feel for Utah. Utah is probably the best player in the year, but I'm super glad and blessed to have like awesome teammates, and it was such a blessing to play with them, and yeah, we had to really
wonderful. Well, another huge round of applause for Tally Bobo Believers, an amazing tournament win, and now we are going to throw it back to our casters.
What a series, what a tournament, what a time for Pokemon Unite. Live here in the London XL Convention Center. You can feel, I mean, the energy in the room is insane. Huge congratulations to Tally Bobo Believers. Once again, they've made a believer out of me.
I don't know how you can't believe in this team at this point. I mean, they even not only were the best team, they came with a little bit of adversity when, you know, Lunderu mentioned one of the best players on the planet wasn't able to play with them. And Lunderu's your sub, you're doing good. I mean, that kid was moving out there, credit to them. Big time win, faced some adversity, fought through the bracket reset, kept their composure, big.
I mean, just an amazing series, one of the best series in Pokemon Unite. We're going to be taking a look at an updated bracket here in just a second so you can see how this played out. Tally Bobo Believers winning the whole way through. In fact, the only time they really stumbled, a couple games with Woof Woof, and then in the grand finals here against Downs Esports. Downs playing their hearts out, but once that bracket reset happened, they were able to turn it on, they were able to get intense and win this thing in commanding fashion. 3-1 against Downs Esports.
I mean, that was just absolutely amazing. Let's take a quick look at what they got today. Tons of money in the bank. Spray with a bunch of great Tally Bobo Believers. Take it home, 10K, and Toon, get a new pair of sneakers.
That's right, Toon gets new shoes, I get new shoes. You know what, I think everybody gets new shoes, obviously, if you can afford
anyone
it,
want to be a personal decision. Is Pokemon Unite team with me?
To you. We've got an exciting season of Pokemon Unite coming, and that felt like the world championship. It really did. We got so much Pokemon Unite coming up. The April finals are happening May 6th, the May finals on May 27th. Then we head on over to the regional finals here in June. We have a lot of
that was good. That was really good. Oh, right. I'm going to head out for a bit. And yeah, come back in. See you there. So, just had another little look at the people who sell the cards and stuff down there. There is a nice little Groudon I might want. Don't know why, but I might want it. Well, I might want to look up online and actually have a little look to see how great a price it is. But yeah, I may go back for that. I was going to some sideband cards that were graded, which is weird to say here. There was one guy selling two Y Schwartz cards. So, you know, aside from that, I haven't bought anything else because I've been too bad with stuff like this and stuff yesterday. It's way too much. So my bank account is hemorrhaging, and it shouldn't hemorrhage anymore. I should be good, a good boy, but I'm not. Eventually, I should also be going home, but you know what? I'm not. I need to go. I want to go to Chaos Madhouse very quick, and yeah. So I'm gonna go to there real quick and just have a little look and see what I can get for my cards at least, and then maybe later on I will buy some stuff. So I traded in some cards at Magic Madhouse, and I got some cards in exchange, which is great. So I did see Rob and Rebecca, which is great. Actually, you ran into me, which is awesome. So I was like, oh, hey. Rob's done really well, actually, so that's really great. So I'm happy for him. Hopefully he got into the top 8, which is amazing. So I hope he actually did get there, because there was a bit of a dispute or something. I can't remember. yeah, so hopefully now, maybe that's him playing, actually. I don't even know. I have to double check so we can get closer. Maybe if I can zoom in my phone.
Zoom in. Not zoomed in enough.
Apparently. Damn. There we go. Robert. I think it says Robert. Oh, shit. It is. Oh, hey. Look at that. He did get in. Well, hot diggity daffodil. My boy. He's down at one game, though. Damn. Come on, son. I believe in you. Look at them fucking... Look at them mad skills. I think. Look at them... What do you call it? Sifting skills, I guess. I don't know. Let's just check it out. Let's check this shit out. I'm going to watch my boy Rob.
Here we go. Travel Bureau, you'll have to get two, so let's just call it double. And this is huge, because now we get to start building up a second one. And I'm not saying Rob has to double electric generator. I am saying it's an option if he wishes to. But what is really important here is that he's going to go ahead and take the KO here, and we don't see an easy response from Alex. Alex would need a metal energy, and it would have to be metal, and he would need the VMAX. If he gets that, he will actually go and get a KO, but it's a very specific two-card combo. You need, does he have it? He's got metal energy.
It's a big chorus here.
He needs the VMAX.
Ultra ball.
Oh, and I think, I'm sure I saw the metal energy in hand.
Slams those Arceus away.
Oh, you can see that there's pressure here. And yeah,
metal energy, so we will be getting a response here with Duranodon VMAX, Ultra Ball Away, Drapion, and Nest Ball. And here we go. The big line of defense that Alex now has is trying to pulverize through Rob's vulnerable two prizes.
Yeah, and this is going to be awkward for Rob, because that Luminion, well easy to KO. The Gardevoir, well easy to KO. Not quite as easy, actually, as Luminion, weirdly, it's a weakness. But this Duranodon, not well easy to KO. The whole, hey, you can attack me if you've got special energy, isn't relevant enough to make me play Duranodon VMAX. But basically, it's a 330 HP Pokemon that hits 220 damage.
Yeah,
that's a lot.
I think to make things difficult for Alex, Rob has to try and use generators to power up his own VMAX here, so that he's not just falling prey to more pulverizations and forcing more gusting cards from Alex. But it looks like, based on Alex's hand, he has a lot of boss's orders already in there. So I think he's got a pretty easy two attack game plan to win the game. Rob has to try and deal with this Duranodon first, and then go about dealing with the Gardevoir.
Yeah, and if you can get the Duraludon, then that's going to be a pretty easy game for Rob. The problem is, getting rid of that Duraludon isn't good. One thing Rob has to be a little careful of, I mean, is it possible to get the Alolan Vulpix back? No, it's actually not. There's no recovery at all in Alex's deck. Okay, so that's fine. So you can go nuts with Pokemon V here. We do have an electric generator in hand.
Yeah, the prizes. This is pretty big.
And there is still the V-Star power from that Forest Seal's Code. So don't generator, I'm just saying, it's still an option.
Well, we've got at least one, and then a professor's research.
Oh, we've got it already. Three, four, come on, five.
Imagine giving that reaction and seeing that many lightning.
From Alex's point of view, he just looked at that and went, oh, Rob didn't hit well off the generator. But in Rob's head, he's like, oh, I would have really called it 5 energy.
Why can't I do as many as I want for the top? Oh my goodness, Rob complaining about seeing too many lightning energy.
It's like, just give me 2 or give me 5. They're giving us 4 in between, Rob. Like I say, I heard rumors that Rob has not been hitting great off generators so far. This match, the generators are coming out.
Drawn into the next. next one as well.
But also drawn into a couple energy. You don't want to draw that many energy. You honestly would love to draw literally everything but energy at this point.
Hello, so it was Rob I was seeing. So yes, obviously, saw a bit of clips there from his match. Unfortunately, he made what stream, he did lose 2-0. Unfortunate. It's a streaming curse. Every time he was on stream, he had bad luck. So, not good. Not good. But he did absolutely amazingly get into top 8. So, good on Rob. Honestly, fucking brilliant on him. So, he did get a case, apparently. He did get a case of booster boxes of Scarlet and Violet. So, pretty decent, if you ask me. So, I don't think it's a bit of prize money or something, I think as well. But either way, pretty decent. So, yeah, I'm just sitting down at the cable cart now, so I'll be going over in a few minutes. I'm here a bit earlier. There's no, I was thinking there was going to be a queue. There wasn't, there isn't. So, yeah, not too bad. So I'm just going to wait for... I'm going to wait, really. Don't need to wait for anything in particular, but... Great. There you go. So, got some bits. Got some bits and bobs. Yeah, I did see between Liam and Tiara stuff, but cute. But I did not say hello. I was thinking the queue's gonna be bad, and I was like, oh, I need to get back home. It's been fucking ages, but probably have time to say hello. But be alright. I'll maybe see him tomorrow, maybe hopefully see how Liam did. That's a movie different line. He's on the stream. Anyway. I will probably see you guys in the cable cart, and we'll end the day off there for day two. In a sec.
And so we look over a lovely, kind of lovely, skylight of London. And then a not so very much lovely. Fucking it's gonna piss down, bro. It's gonna piss down, son, I tell ya. Jesus, look at that.
I still don't know what they're fucking doing here. It's been like this for fucking donkey years. And I don't know what they're doing.
I mean, if I can clear all that out, whatever the hell they're doing. Got two little things there.
I really, really want to know what they're doing down there. I just don't get it. I really, really don't get it. But there's the Excel Centre. In the distance, in the sun. Look at that. Very, very lovely. That's a wrap on day two. Thanks, Pokemon. Play Pokemon Twitter. Thanks for letting me know. So, yeah. That's it. Day two is officially over. One more day, and that is the end of the TCG and end of the VG. So yeah, goes finished. Unite obviously finished. Oh,
I think you talk about the Unite. What a fucking finish that Unite guys had. Oh my god, that was amazing. I need to get back into Unite. I need to get back into everything. I need to get back into VG, Unite, and go. But it's a problem. You can't play them all. You really cannot play them all. So, just coming down now. So, we'll go over the O2 and yeah. I shall see you guys tomorrow for day 3. See you guys then. Peace.